Hi everybody, can you believe this is our last day of Mega Sports Camp for the week? You guys have done such an amazing job and we're so happy that you were able to send us pictures so we can see your different crazy hair and jerseys and singing and different things that you've done throughout the week. Again, we so wish that we could have been with you this year, but are glad that we were able to still hold Mega Sports Camp virtually. So today for our last Spirit Day, it is Red, White, and Blue Day. So after this video, go get your red, white, and blue clothes on and send us a picture. So for our recap, yesterday's mega point is that Jesus saves us from our sins. So can you just say that with me? Jesus saves us from our sins. Coach Megan read from John chapter 18 and 21, and we saw that Peter denied Jesus. Peter thought this could never happen, but in that moment when he was worried and scared, he did deny Jesus. I bet that was pretty hurtful to Jesus, don't you think? But we know that Jesus died for all of our sins, and he died for that sin as well, and he forgave Peter, just like he forgives us of all of our sins. Peter was then called to tell the whole world about Jesus, which leads to our next mega point for today. Jesus has an amazing plan to do great things with our lives. So Coach Megan is going to tell you more about that. And right now, we're gonna transition to our last time of singing together. So if you wanna get up on your feet and sing your hearts out and get ready to hear the Bible story and also to check out Coach Lori's physical challenge. Have a great week and we hope to see you soon. Bye.
Bible says that Jesus wants to be with me. The Bible says he cares when I am blue. The Bible says that Jesus was a joyful human man. So how would he live with me and you? Would he be Jesus the soccer star? Jesus wants to be with me.
That's right.
The Bible says he cares when I am blue. Boo. The Bible says that Jesus was a joyful human man. So how would he live with me and you? Would he? Hey, I just can't.
before I go, 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 I stop. Before I go, 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 I stop. Before I go, I stop. I don't want my day to flop. Before I go, 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 I stop. Before I run, 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 I walk. Before I run, 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 I walk. Before I run, I walk. I sit with the Lord and talk. Before I run, 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 I walk. And then I go all out beyond any doubt. I want my life to shout, God is alive in me. And then I go all out beyond any doubt. I want my life to shout, God is alive in me.
A big, big table with lots and lots of food. A big, big come and go with me to my Father's house. Come and go with me to my Father's house. It's a big, big house with lots and lots of room. A big, big table with lots and lots of food. A big, big yard where we can play football. A big, big house. It's my Father's house. A big, big house with lots and lots of room. It's my Father's house.
Hey guys, happy Friday. This is our last Mega Sports Camp video for the week. I'm so happy that you have taken part in this virtual experience, and I hope that you have enjoyed yourself. All right guys, so we have been learning about Jesus and Peter and their relationship and what it was like for Peter to be a follower of Jesus. We've seen Peter like kind of have some really high highs and some really low lows, right? Like when Peter was first met Jesus and Jesus, you know, told him to follow him and Peter said, sure, yeah, he left everything behind, right? And we learned that Peter was valued because he was created by God and God knew that Peter had a certain set of talents, a certain set of abilities, a certain heart that God gave him. And Peter was valuable, right? Peter was valuable to Jesus and Jesus came to this earth so that he could die for the sins of all people who believe in him, including Peter. And that also includes you. So we learned on our first day that we are valued. On our second day, we learned that God is here. We saw Peter step out on the water, keeping his eyes on Jesus. He was able to walk on water. But as soon as he took his eyes off of Jesus, he started to sink, right? If we can remember that God is here with us as believers and followers of Jesus and keep our eyes fixed on Jesus, study his word, pray when we need, pray every day, pray, ask God for things, pray and tell God that he is wonderful and praise him. If we can do those things and keep our eyes fixed on Jesus, we too will be strengthened and we too will be able to do many amazing things. Then the next day, we learned that God transforms us from the inside out. God transforms our hearts. We saw Peter boldly call Jesus the Son of the Living God. Whoo, that was a big deal for that time, right? He told Jesus that who he thought he was, and that was a very courageous thing to do. But he was only able to do it because God had been working in Peter's heart that whole time. He had been growing a faith in Peter and a trust in Jesus. And so when Jesus asked that question, Peter was able to say, "You are the Son of the Living God." No one else was able to say that, but God had been transforming Peter's heart. And so he was able to say it and to act on his faith that was in his heart. Pretty cool, huh? The next thing we learned was yesterday, we saw that Jesus forgives us of our sins. That we can be forgiven of our sins. And we saw this with just an incredible example, right? Jesus and Peter, such good friends, such good friends. And Peter, a devoted follower of Jesus, always looking to honor Jesus and follow him and do what he wants him to do. But in the moment of just a very intense time when Jesus was arrested, Peter denied Jesus three times, saying he didn't know him. And he really sinned there, you know? He denied even knowing Jesus. And he denied who Jesus was. And he denied even being Jesus' friend. That was a really hurtful thing, right? But Jesus has a heart to forgive us. Jesus has a heart to bring people together and to bring us together with God. So we found out that Jesus forgives Peter for that. And that Jesus' death on the cross paid for the sin that Peter did when he said, "I don't know who Jesus is," when he denied Jesus. Jesus took the punishment for that. So today we are going to see the next part of the story. And the next part of the story happens after Jesus leaves this earth. So Jesus dies on the cross and he's put in a tomb. And 3 days later, the tomb is empty. Jesus comes back to life.
His body stands up. He's able to walk. He's able to breathe. His disciples are able to touch the holes in his hand from where the nails had gone. It was a miracle. It was amazing. Jesus came back to life. And after Jesus spent some time with his disciples, he told his disciples, I'm going to go to my Father in heaven. I'm going to leave this earth. I'm not going to be here anymore. And they were kind of sad to hear that. But Jesus said, I need to go, because when I go, someone even better is coming. And what he was referring to was the Holy Spirit. See, God is so amazing that God is three beings in one. It's one God, and it's God the Father, and God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, right? Jesus talks to his Father. We see that when Jesus prays to God when he's alive on this earth, right? But then Jesus dies and he rises again. He comes back to life, and he is walking around, and he knows that he needs to go back to heaven so the Father and the Son can be back together. But the Holy Spirit is this part of God who comes to us and fills our hearts and speaks to us while we're living right here. I mean, yeah, it's so cool that the disciples got to know Jesus physically and like give him a high five, right? But we, as believers in Jesus now, and Peter, after Jesus ascended to heaven, just went up to heaven, we're given the Holy Spirit, God's Spirit living inside of us. It's pretty cool, huh? So this happens, and all of these amazing things start happening, because now suddenly Peter and the other disciples are filled with God's Holy Spirit and God's power, and God gives them the ability to do amazing things. Suddenly they are able to perform miracles, and they're able to speak in different languages so that other people can understand. And they're able to preach and teach the good news to people who had never heard it before. And that is exactly what Peter did. And God always knew that Peter would get to this point. God always knew, even way back when Peter was just a fisherman, God knew that Peter had certain talents and certain abilities, and God created Peter a certain way, that after God worked in Peter's heart and grew his faith and transformed him, and after Jesus died on the cross and came back to life and then rose into heaven, God knew that Peter would be able to preach the good news of the gospel to many, many people. And you know what happened? He did it, and thousands of people came to believe in Jesus. Peter started the church. Jesus told Peter, I am going to use you to build my church. And Peter did just that, because he followed God. He honored him. He called him who he was. He said, Jesus, you are the Son of the living God. He asked for forgiveness of his sins. And then God sent his Holy Spirit so that Peter can go out and do amazing things for God. So I want to go over what exactly was the good news that Peter was sharing with everyone. Well, if you come to Mega Sports Camp, you know that every year we do something called the Wordless Book. And obviously we can't do that because we're not together. But I do have these papers, and I want to go over it with you now, because I feel like it just helps us understand the gospel so, so well. All right. Let me make sure I'm in order here, guys. All right, so the first color paper we have is yellow. All right, and yellow reminds us of heaven, right? God loves us all so much, and he wants us to be with him in heaven. Right now we're on this earth, but after we die, we can be with God in eternity if we believe in Jesus. And God wants us to be with him so, so much. But something sad happened. After God created the earth and he created men and women, he created Adam and Eve, we saw sin come into the world. And we use a dark color to represent sin, because God is just beautiful light, right? So this dark color shows us sin. It brings darkness. And the sin separated us from God. See, God is so holy and perfect. He can't be with sin. Sin has to be paid for. And when we sin, we need to pay for it in some way. So sin brings darkness. It reminds us that we sinned and we cannot be with God. Raise your hand if you've ever sinned. I've sinned. I've sinned a lot. Every single person sins except for Jesus. So guys, sin. This dark color reminds us that we have sinned and we cannot be with God. All right, red. Red reminds us of the blood of Jesus. Now, I know that sounds a little icky, right? But you remember that Jesus went to the cross and died. They had to put nails in his hands and his feet. He had a crown of thorns on his head. Jesus lived a perfect life and he did not deserve any punishment. But he died for our sins. He took our punishment away from us. And in doing that, he bled. So we're reminded of Jesus's blood that pays for our sins, takes our punishment on the cross. All right, the next one is this white paper. And this white paper reminds us of something that is clean. Because you see, guys, once you believe in Jesus, you are wiped clean of all of your sins. We will be made clean. When God looks at us, he doesn't see the bad things we've done. He sees the goodness and the amazingness and the cleanness of Jesus, right? Because Jesus never sinned when he was on this earth. Jesus gives us that cleanness. He gives us that freedom from sin. That doesn't mean you'll never sin in your life. If you choose to follow Jesus today, you're still gonna sin. But what it means is that Jesus has already paid for that sin and you've accepted his gift. And then finally, we have green. And green reminds us that it's important for us to grow our relationship with Jesus. See, it's all well and good that Jesus paid for our sins on the cross, right? And he has this gift waiting for us to clean us of all of our sins. But we have to say yes to it, right? When someone gives you a gift on Christmas morning and you have the box and you're holding it and you go and you unwrap it, right? And you take it for yourself and you say thank you. We need to do the same thing with what Jesus has done for us. Jesus died on the cross. He bled his blood so that if we choose to follow him, if we say yes, Jesus, if we believe in Jesus, then we are made clean and we have accepted his gift and Jesus begins to grow us, right? Then we have a relationship with him. And you know what's really cool? Once you choose to believe in Jesus, you are changed instantly. And then God continues to grow you and strengthen your faith and to grow you like a sturdy, big tree, right? So that's what the green reminds us of. So guys, I don't know where you're at in your own faith, but I know this. Jesus loved you so much and saw you as valuable. So he came down from heaven to this earth to be with you and to make a way for you to be with him forever. All you have to do is say, Jesus, I'm sorry for my sins. I know that I sin and I want to follow you. I believe in you. Help me to trust you more every day. So if you think you're ready to pray that prayer with me, I want you to pray with me. I want you to close your eyes right now. And I want you to pray and I want you to just repeat the words after me. Okay, here we go. Dear God, I know that I sin. I know that I do wrong. Even though sometimes I do good, I still do wrong. I know that you love me, God, and I thank you for sending Jesus to this earth. Jesus, I'm sorry for my sins. Thank you for dying on the cross for me. I believe in you. Please come into my heart and help me to follow you all the days of my life. Amen. All right, guys, if you prayed that today, what I want you to do is I want you to tell somebody. Go and tell your mom, your dad, your grandma, your grandpa. Let someone know, okay? And you can let me know too, because I'd love to pray for you as you begin your walk in faith with Jesus. All right, everybody, so wonderful to see you. I hope you have a great, great day. And we have had fun doing this, and I am looking forward to the time where we can be in each other's presence doing all these crazy fun things together. Until then, I'm praying for you. We miss you, and we will talk to you soon. Bye.
When we join
Team Jesus,
we learn about God, and soon we start to
believe it.
Listen to your call so you can
play by the rules.
We're not here to play games.
It's about to get real.
I am an overcomer. On His word I stand. I am more than a conqueror. It's His plan. We are called the God. He is the ultimate coach. So let's get fired up. Yeah, come on, let's go. Omega. Together, cause we're
all one team.
Learning about sports.
Yeah, you know that's right.
We're not here to play games.
It's about real life.
We're pressing on towards the goal. Having all the fun we can.